have in front of you all. We love performing. This is the Jazz Band. And we, yes. Concerts are my favorite time because we get a chance to play and perform what we've been working on for so long with the semester. So we opened the concert with Heatseeker, Rock Chart, and we're about to move on to a funk chart, Gandy Dancer. Instrumental music here at SHC. And again, it's always great to be here in front of all of my students' parents and loved ones and family. This is why we do what we do. I want to introduce some members of the ensemble. I'll start with the rhythm section over on Vibes. We have Rowan. On drum set, Shane. On bass, we have Dante. On guitar, we have Tommy. And Liam. And on keys over here, we have Lucas. Some of these guys have been playing in jazz band for 3 years. Three years now, so it's been a ride. Our next piece, we try to... one more thing, actually, before I move on to the next piece. This group in particular, the official title is Contraband Honors. So they're an honors course, and so they not only meet for contraband, which you'll hear later in the program, but they also meet separately for jazz rehearsal. What's really special about Sacred Heart Cathedral is that our students get the chance to do it all. While they're here on campus, they do not only music and BPA, but they also get the chance to do sports and other things that they enjoy. So almost everyone in here plays some sort of sport, I've learned, whether it's baseball or volleyball or track or whatever. And I really enjoy having well-rounded students. So this year, this semester, we changed from we would rehearse last fall, like Tuesday, Thursday after school, from 2:45 to 4, and this year, because we had so many conflicts with practices after school, and I really want my students to be able to try everything, so we actually started rehearsing 7 a.m. every time we had a Founders Day. So again, give them some applause for all of this happened with one day a week, one rehearsal a week for about 2 hours, 7 a.m., and then they go off to class for the rest of the day, so they work extremely hard, and they do such a great job, so I'm really proud of them for that. I also woke up early too. I woke up even earlier, so I got breakfast. One really special thing about jazz band as well is that we get a chance to play a lot of different genres, different styles of jazz, whether it's rock or funk we just play. Now we're gonna move on to a Latin chart, a samba called Skylanter. Thank you. yeah, that one was especially fun to come together because it was so different for us to kind of get that samba feel, but it ended up being one of our favorite pieces to work up. Moving on with my introductions, I'll start with the wind section. On alto sax, we have Madison. I forget, the only girl in our ensemble. Then we have on tenor sax, Matthew Simpson. And on bass sax, Jonah. And for our brass, on trombone, we have Luca. Trumpet, Matthew Shork. Also on trumpet, we have Keon. And lead trumpet, Nick Katz. So this next piece is super special because we get a chance to, one of my favorite things is working with my colleagues, working with the chorus, working with the dance, working with drama. And so oftentimes I'm always looking, I'm always listening, I'm always searching for, you know, who are the stars within not only my department, but also the other visual performing arts departments as well. So I'm always listening and hearing what's going on in the other groups, and I want to feature a vocalist on our jazz set. So vocal jazz is a huge faction of jazz repertoire, and feeling good is such a staple in that as well. And this particular senior who's going to join us is accomplished, is smart, is one of the chorus co-presidents, and just has been a force at SHU these last 4 years. And I've been dying to get a chance to really work with her, and it's been such a pleasure and such a joy, and I know she's going to do great things next year after she graduates. So without further ado, please, please welcome Lauren Danielle Moran to the stage.
It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on a tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Oh, sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me. Thank you. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling, oh, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. So good, I'm feeling
good. Can we give her one more hand? It just goes to show how much depth we have of talent here at SHC, just without, not just instrumentalists. I love getting a chance to feature every other discipline on our concerts, because that's what music is all about, playing and making music and making art with your friends. And that's what we do, that's what we love to do, that's why we're here. So, before our last piece, this is our last concert with our seniors, and these seniors, this class has been so special in a lot of ways. They were able to get through the pandemic, that year of distance learning, and came out stronger. Actually, I had a lot of students go back over the break and come back so much stronger and so much just different and taller. And it's strange. It's really strange. So, and it's been such a joy to see. I think we always talk about, as educators, or people always mention, you know, oh, you made such an impact on their life, but we don't ever talk about how much of an impact they make on our lives. And this group has made such an impact on my life. And we talked, and we did a little thing before this, and it's going to be emotional tonight, so just be prepared. So I have a couple of awards, actually. To highlight some of people in our ensemble that have just been doing an excellent job this year, and I wanted to give them a little shout out. So, I actually get some help, somebody in tech, to hold these really quick. Someone in tech? Somebody in tech? Come here. Okay, never mind. Come here, Noah. Noah! So I'll start with most improved. Most improved doesn't mean that you started off bad. It just means that I've seen such a growth over the year, that's been almost immeasurable. And I really want to highlight a student that started off on a secondary instrument, and I wasn't sure how it was going at first, and the sounds were interesting, and they became such a staple and honestly one of our best players. And so most improved goes to Matthew Simpson. Okay, and also in jazz we do what's called improvisation. Playing and making music just based off chords and that kind of structure, and making all the melodies and the harmonies on our own. And so we do that a lot in jazz. It's what jazz is, essentially. And so I have some students that, again, referencing the pandemic, left, and I think they both got into lessons. I think so. They got into lessons and just came back like jazz cat monsters, like improv like crazy. And it was insane, and I'm still honestly floored every day when I hear them. So Best Improv this year goes to two students. The first is Liam Hansberry. And the second, this is why I have an improv last usually on every song, goes to Nick Katz. Yeah. And the last award. This is a very special award because it highlights sort of an overall just great musician, great student, great person in our ensemble. I have so many, it's really hard to give out awards because if I gave one to everyone, I really would. But it's impossible, so I really wanted to highlight this student. They're always there, they're reliable, they're prepared. I never really have to say anything to them. I notice sometimes in rehearsal I don't ever have to call them out at all because they always are perfect. So, or close to perfect. And it's inspiring because I always say that I want to be the teacher that I always wanted when I was a student. I want someone to, you know, to tell me straight up what I need to work on and to be encouraging, and I had a glimpse of that, and I that's what I strive to be. And this student is I've had such a joy working with them the last few years, and I hope that I know they're going to have a great future after this. So the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award this year goes to Dante, though. Jazz is set with a medley of The Incredibles.
table near the street, in our old familiar place, you and I face to face. Bottle of red, bottle of white, it all depends upon your appetite. I'll meet you anytime you want in our Italian restaurant. whatever kind of mood you're in tonight. I'll meet you anytime you want in our Italian restaurant.
This next piece by the percussion ensemble that's on stage right now. So, going into this school year, I think all of my percussionists graduated but one person, but Rowan. So, I was a little nervous because I didn't know what was going to happen. And I think everybody else here is new or freshman. Besides Rowan. So I was just nervous, you know, everyone's a little nervous prior going into a year, not really knowing the chemistry that a section might have or the connectedness. And I was shocked to see that, you know, I switched some people off, some instruments to percussion, and I was, you know, a little apprehensive about how that would go. And like we have Allie over here on tambourine as a pianist, as well as Anthony and Ivan. They were all playing piano at first, and then they all either offered or I switched them to percussion, and they've been just great in our section and in our group. Alessandro back there on bass drum was in my beginner class, just started playing this year, refreshing. He played a little bit way back in the day, but so our group and everyone else are freshmen. So our group is just, I was, you know, they were sort of like a ragtag group of percussionists that came together and became one of the strongest sections in our band. And so we decided to feature them on a percussion ensemble piece. I can't take any of the credit for preparing this piece. It's all done by our percussion coordinator, who unfortunately isn't here this evening, Mr. Kurt Moore. And he's, for those of you who don't know, he's been at SHC longer than I have, and I'm not even sure how long he's been here, but he's seen so many different music directors, and I've had the privilege of working with him. He's a professional musician, gigs around the Bay Area, and teaches private lessons, and we're very lucky to have him, and I wanted to give him some recognition even though he's not here tonight. So he prepared this piece, and I'm here to conduct it.
Thank you.
So the group that we see on stage right now is the String Orchestra, and we have had such a, it's been a pleasure working with them all year. They have a lot of work to do over the year because they're the group that the school calls to play at luncheons, they play at masses, they play at anything fancy and special you can think of, we're there playing. And so it kind of adds a lot to our plate, and they do such a great job at balancing that with all the other classes and making such special music together. And it's been such a pleasure. We're also joined by a few special guests that I'll get to throughout the program. First, I want to highlight some of our student musicians that are helping us out this evening. On piano, the first piece we had helped by Abby Chang, who's also here page turning today. The last piece featured Grant Ching on piano as well. This piece will feature Matthew Brazil. And our jazz pianist, Lucas Havlin, will join us for our last piece in the program. And also, for this piece, we're also joined by two student percussion players, Rowan and Shane. Both of them are back to the stage for the third or fourth time tonight already. So, our program is, I speak a lot about, I'm really passionate about diversity and repertoire and picking pieces that push our students to get to that next level and push them to, kind of push in the process different kinds of music. And so we go from classical, we start off with the Mozart overture and going on to something lyrical. And now we're gonna play one of, I think, my favorite piece of all of, on the entire program to rehearse. It's called An Evil Eye and the Hideous Heart. It's based off of, they pull material from Edgar Allan Poe's The Telltale Heart. And so it's programmatic in theme. And so you'll hear a lot of, I think it's more effect than anything else. And it's been such a joy to work up, so I really hope that you enjoy this piece.
Thank you.
Special guests, there's no way that I could do this job by myself. There's so many moving parts, and I, for a string ensemble, I'm joined by Mr. Andres Vera, who you all know. We all know and love. He is here with us every class, here in rehearsal, and one thing that I really appreciate, he helps me out so much with just orchestra and everything that goes into our class and helping out our students and teaching lessons after school, and helps us all remember to find joy in music. And that's what we kind of just soak it up from him in rehearsal and performance every day. So super thankful for him. And another thing that we decided to implement this year were having a few conservatory students from the San Francisco Conservatory of Music come and join us as well. And I'd actually like to invite Mr. Vera up to talk about that a little bit.
I can talk from here.
Here's the mic.
So, you know, it's the role of you know, we have mentors in our lives, and we have people who play instruments, have been playing instruments longer than we have. It's always great to learn something from them. There are musicians that are older than me that I always still, to this day, learn something from them. And so I've invited these professionals. Jennifer, please stand up. Jessica, please stand up. Please give them a round of applause, please. Cody and Alisa on the bass. They are here to play a side-by-side experience for our students. For me, when I was younger, playing alongside professionals was the thing that really made the difference for me and inspired me to continue playing and continue my career as a cellist. So thank you so much to the professionals for being here, and also thanks to the students for welcoming them here with us today. Thank you so much, Mr. Cumberbatch.
I completely agree. The way to get better is to surround yourself with people that are strong, that you can learn from, and that's what we all do every day. And I'm really happy that we decided to do this year, and thankful for the string fellows and their hard work this semester. So here we go.
Thank you.
our set for orchestra. Can I have Noah out here again? Where's Noah? Noah! A few exceptional students in our string orchestra. The first is the Director's Award for Freshmen. This one highlights an outstanding freshman that it's hard to come into high school. Our ensembles are all mixed. They're in all 9 through 12. We don't have any freshman groups or sophomore groups or anything like that. They're all mixed for the most part, besides jazz, which is also mixed. But it's hard to come into high school and to join and be playing next to seniors and sophomores and juniors, and the freshmen do it exceptionally, and this freshman class throughout both band and orchestra has been exceptional. They've been such a strong group and such a vivacious, happy, energetic group, and I've just really noticed in this ensemble of freshmen, he stands out so much, and sometimes I forget that he's a freshman. I always think, I'm like, wait, is he a sophomore or junior? Because he's mature and he plays so maturely. And we're really happy to have him this year. The Director's Award for Freshmen goes to Brandon Holland. And I have one more award to give out. This is the highest award given to a student in orchestra. It's the National School Orchestra Award. And it's awarded to a student who has been exceptional and consistent throughout their time here at SHC. This student, I'm just floored by how talented they are across disciplines. And I learn more about them each day and every year. And I really enjoy having them in rehearsal and their presence. They're such a grounding sort of support for our ensemble. And when they're not there, when they're not in class, it's we definitely miss them. So I want to give the National School Orchestra Award to Maya Kuo. Some of her friends at Guitar Club, and then I don't know how it happened. I don't know if you came to me, it was my first year, so I didn't know anybody, and somehow she communicated that she wanted to learn string bass, upright bass, and we got our lessons, we got her in orchestra, and the rest is history. So we're really excited about you, Maya, and thanks a lot. All right. And we're going to conclude with a piece, You Are Amazing, by Brian Balmages. This is our concert band, and this is always my favorite semester with this group, because in the fall, we double as a marching band, and we're at the football games and at every other game that we're called to be at, and we always have a lot of fun doing that. But in the spring, we get a chance to just sit and play music and make beautiful sounds with each other. And so the first piece was a Sousa march, the Thunderer. If you know anything about a traditional band setting, you always play a Sousa march. Marches are a staple in our concert band repertoire, and Sousa is, his nickname was the March King. Anybody knows John Philip Sousa, and we had a good time working at that. Then we followed it by Risk Everything for a Dream, which was a nice lyrical piece, and that really pushed us to get to that next level lyrical playing, because we always were used to playing fast and loud and bashful, but to play smooth and connected and lyrical was a challenge, but I think we did a really good job, and I always pick pieces, I talked about this with orchestra, that pushes us to the next level, and that piece certainly did, and I had a great time working that up with them. If you can see in the program, the next piece is called Snakes, and it's also another piece that is all about the effects, so there's going to be some visuals happening, so if you feel if you feel a little squeamish at any time, feel free to listen with your eyes closed, all right?
Thank you.
dark and twisty concert. That's number two on the program. it's gonna happen one of these days. That piece in particular, that's something that I've been looking at for so many years and been wanting to do it with a group and could never find the right kind of configuration of students to do it. And this group, I was like, oh, we're gonna do it. So it was so much fun. I hope no one was freaked out too much by snakes. But it was such a joy to work up. Noah. I have some more awards to give out for our band members. I'm going to start with Most Improved again. This is just, this on this one first. I've mentioned before, I have a group of sophomores, my beginner class, and they join their sophomore year with little to no experience in music, and they just integrate themselves into our band by the end of the year. So actually, can you four sophomores that are with us for my beginner class stand up, please? This is all their first year playing, for most of them, their first year playing at least these instruments, and our first year in a while, so it's been such a treat to have them join us, and they've worked extremely hard to catch up in a way, and to keep up with everyone else that's been playing for years. So this first award, Most Improved, goes to someone from that group, and every day I'm floored by how much they enjoy playing music, and how much they want to be in the big concert band class and to break out of the beginner class, and I've just been so impressed all year by what they've been able to achieve. And so this first Most Improved Award goes to Luis Esquivel Gomez. And the second Most Improved Award is so very special to me, because this student, a couple years ago, I was not sure. I'm going to be honest, I was not sure at all what their future was, but I don't know if it was the pandemic, they left and they came back completely different, and not just for me, consensus from all of their teachers. I met with all their teachers, we all stopped each other, like, can you believe that they made such an improvement? I'm like, no, I couldn't believe it. And they're so resourceful, so reliable, so responsible, and I've just seen such a 180 in terms of everything, every aspect of their musicianship and their person. And I'm so, so proud of this person, and it's only up from here. So the second Most Improved Award goes to Rowan Clinch. Almost 20 are freshmen, so I had a huge freshman class, and they've been so strong, so picking this award was tough, so I actually couldn't decide. There were two people that really stand out, both fantastic musicians, both have excelled this year, and again, I just forget that they're freshmen, because they're so mature, and they play so strong, and they fit into our group so seamlessly. So the first director's award goes to Matthew Bazile. Been on stage like at least three or four times tonight already, so they really help us out a lot. Oh, I have a few awards that just highlight a few students that are just outstanding. Just outstanding musicians and are staples in our ensemble, and I couldn't be more proud of them and the progress they've made. The first one goes to, I'll do this one first. The first one goes to a student that is just, has so much passion, so much energy, and it surprises me every day with what they can do and how much they care about our band as a whole. So this first Outstanding Musicianship Award goes to Madison Lee. And the last one goes to a student who, again, I always think, like, this student just came out of nowhere. I had no idea who they were. I don't know if they knew who anybody the band was, but then they just joined during the pandemic, and they've been with us ever since, and I couldn't imagine it without them now. So this award goes to Tommy Zaterka. Okay, and one last award for band. It's the John Philip Sousa Award. This award is, just like the Director's Award, the National School Orchestra Award, it's nationally recognized, and it's the highest award given to a student in band, usually given to a senior. This senior has, it's hard to find the words to describe them, because they do so much, not only with us, but with other groups across campus. They're a leader among, across campus, which is hard sometimes to get them to. I want them to be in band 100% of the time, but they're always doing this, they're doing that, and I support it because I see how much they thrive and how I'm always emailing their teachers like, not gonna have them for this block. No, wait, you're gonna have them after school. I'll take them in the morning. Like it's like a gamble. So I know they're gonna do well next year, off to college, and I'm just so proud of them. They have shown their versatility and their wittedness, and I just couldn't be more proud of Jonah Nelson. So I hope you enjoy our last piece, Dark Red. But I do have a few more thank yous, because I, again, cannot do this job by myself. And I'd like to thank some of our amazing, amazing administrators at Sacred Heart Cathedral. I'd like to thank, first of all, our president, Dr. Melinda Screedy. Our principal, Dr. Gary Cannon. Both of our assistant principals, Christine Buell. And Jill O'Neill. Both of our deans of students, Mario Sazzo and Nicole Massari. I'd like to thank Thursa and Giselle and the Office of Communications for helping with the promotion and the flyer, the posters, and the programs. They do so much work for us, and I really want to thank them for that. Of course, our string coaches, our fellows, our percussion coordinator, Mr. Kurt Moore, who's not here tonight. There's so many people that helped me do this, because there's so many moving parts, and there's no way I can do it on myself. Absolutely no way. So, and I really appreciate the support from my colleagues, my VPA colleagues, Rhonda Smith, Spencer Morris, Michael Kirshner, Laura Wexler, Brian McHugh, Tai Chu, all of the VPA. They help me in more ways than one. Thank you also to the parents. Thank you, parents. Give yourself a hand. You're the reason why they're here. You foster their love of music, and you support them. It's so important, I think, to at this age be supported with your passions. Is parents supporting their students' passions? Because a lot of people don't have that, and I was fortunate enough to have that, which is why I'm standing here today. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for supporting your students, because I get a chance to work with them. And thank you for raising such responsible, talented. students in music, you know, we know that they just do so much, do so well, so much better than everyone else, because they are, I mean, that's the truth, they do so much better because they're here, and they push themselves to the next level, and I couldn't be more proud as a teacher. Thank you to my wonderful friends, I don't know where they are. Thanks for coming out tonight and supporting me as well. I can't see them, but they're here somewhere. They're all like, you have friends? it's been a wild ride, and it's been a great year, and we have just a few more weeks left. Graduation, all the end of the year activities, and I just am so happy to end it with this group on stage. So we're gonna end with our final piece, Pirates of the Caribbean, but before that, we have a quick slideshow featuring the seniors.
May God's blessing keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous. Stand upright and be strong. And may you stay. Forever young.
before we go on, can we just get some lights on stage, please, tech crew? I just wanna one last time acknowledge the seniors. When I call your name, please stand. I'm gonna make sure I don't forget anyone, so I have to count on my hands. Marika. Kendra. Kristen. Raven. And Maya. So first is Jonah, Luca, Nick, Lucas, Liam, Tommy, Dante. I didn't miss anybody, did I?
Rowan.
No. Yes. Okay. All right. Here we go. Here's our last key. Oh. Okay.
Before we play our final song, we wanted to thank some individuals who helped put on this show.
Hello, everyone. My name is Johnny. I am the stage manager. It's been such a pleasure working with everyone from Lights Down, Hila, to these wonderful musicians. I would like to give a thank you to Mr. Mahoney. I decided to make you some fake ones. We did put in some real ones, you know, just for fun. But we also wanted to do a little homage to snakes, because that was amazing. I was gonna say. But yeah, thank you.
Next, we'd like to thank Ms. Smith. She's the head of the VPA department, and also the fun department. Always helping us behind the scenes is always being so supportive and is just always there for us. Thank you. Okay, up next we'd like to thank Mr. Bear again. Basically, he teaches, I think most of us, in lessons and stuff, just helping us get the technical stuff down and really helping us as an ensemble. I know that I probably would have never learned how to play bass without you, so thank you for everything you do.
I get to thank someone who is not here right now, but this is Mr. Moore, the legendary Mr. Moore. We would not be this percussion section that we are without him. He is famous for his sarcasm, and it helps us get through every day. So we notice he always brings a thermos of coffee every day. So I bought him some Pike Place roast from Starbucks. And we kind of want to talk about the thing around it.
Yeah, so this thing, I made it myself. It is a drawstring coffee sock for him. Yeah, so let's hope he enjoys his coffee every single day now.
So this is a joint one for Mr. Cumberbatch. First, we'll give you the very nice, normal thing, not the weird thing. But I think for everyone in band and orchestra, he kind of holds all of us together. I know, like, at least for the seniors, a bunch of us are really busy, and he yells at us to make sure that we make time for this, because we really should, and we always regret when we don't, but without him, none of this would have happened, none of this would have been as good as it had, so that's the official part. Here's the fun part.
This might be weird or cool, I don't really know how you'll take this, but I'm sure you all know that Mr. Cumberbatch is a very funny person, and he has very good, quick one-liners. And so we collected them and wrote Cumberbatchisms, the comprehensive guide.
give. I'll read one. Okay, I'll read this bonus quote. You guys have... Take this with a grain of salt. There's no context behind this. That's the point. You guys have an attention span like this. I don't know how you guys do your classes. Okay, let me see. That's the truth. Kalia's cat keeps falling off her roof. Your dog, Pierre, right? Your dog, Pierre, I know his name because he keeps falling off the roof. I said it's like a cat falling off Kalia's roof. The way they sound. We're working on things. Sometimes there's interesting sounds. We kept going even though we could have stopped a million times because a lot of it wasn't right. Okay, these are, again, there's no context behind them, but thank you for this. Okay. But seriously, here's the deal. I see them sometimes in class when I'm talking. They're like, oh yeah, write that one down. And I've noticed it lately. I started noticing it because I've figured out what's going on, but I at least they're listening. somewhat. I will say, going off of that, the group that you see on stage, the level of talent and the level of repertoire we're able to play now, when I got here, you know, 3 years ago, that was not the case. They've been through so many changes in directors, and it was just a tough time for them. So I kind of inherited a group that was not necessarily untalented, but just lacks a lot of confidence in themselves and their ability. And me being here, I don't want to even take credit for it. I think it's all just me pushing them in the right direction. And I've seen such a change. It's a different group, completely different group. And I hope that they know that they couldn't have tried to word this. I hope that they know that it makes sense in my head. Basically, they're doing stuff that I never thought that they're doing stuff that I always thought they could do, that maybe they didn't think so, and I just had to push them to get there. And so I really hope that they understand that they're able to do so much more than they think. That's what I was trying to say. I just see so much potential, not only musically, but academically and socially and personally. I really, really enjoy everyone on stage, and it's just the best job I've ever had, the only job I've had, but the best students I've had. So thank you. So here we go. We're gonna play the last piece so you guys can go home.
Thank you.
One last thing. I have two more very special awards to give out. I wanted to save the best for last because these two students are more than exceptional. There's the last award. It's called the Leonard Bernstein Musicianship Award. Leonard Bernstein is one of the most famous orchestral conductors ever to have lived. He was the conductor of the New York Phil for, he had a tenure of around, like, I think 58 to 69 or something. I did a paper on him in grad school, but he is, when you think about music and musicianship and joy in music, and that's, you think of Leonard Bernstein. They're actually making a movie, Maestro, I think it's Bradley Cooper is starring. It's coming up soon. I don't know why it wasn't called, why it wasn't cast, but, you know, whatever. But, probably because I'm not Jewish, but so look out for that. But this award, again, it's nationally recognized, and it's just, there's a band award, there's an orchestra award, but this one is an overall musicianship award. And I've had two students over the last few years that I, again, am so impressed every day. And they're leaders, and they lead the ensemble, and everyone follows them inside rehearsal and outside of rehearsal. They lead by example. Their playing is strong. Their personality is mature. It's responsible. They're reliable, and they have a lot of fun. And they're such a joy to teach. And I could go on and on about them for days, and we don't have a lot of time. But I could talk about them all night long. I'm just so proud of them, and I know they're off to do great things. And I don't know, it's really hard to see them go. It really is. And I get emotional thinking about it because, you know, it, again, students touch our lives more than they realize. And it's so special, and these two are so special. So, you know, I don't think it's any surprise, but the Leonard Bernstein Musicianship Award goes to two students, both of who happen to be our presidents of band and orchestra, Nick Katz and Marika Rosenfeld. We have to get the chairs and stands back to the room really quick, so please stay and do that. Parents, I'd love to meet you all and family outside briefly after this, so please stick around. I'd love to meet you if I haven't, or just say hi again, take some pictures, whatever. So stick around. Thank you for coming tonight. Have a great rest of your evening.